The Colgate Comedy Hour. Starring Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis. With their guests, Connie Russell, Ray Malone, Danny Arnold, Ira Grossell, Bernie Schwartz, and Pepe Willow. Presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feed Company, makers of Colgate Dental Cream. Palmolive Brushless Shaving Cream. Fav, the new wash day suds. And Palmolive Soap. And now the singing star of our show, Dean Martin.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, tonight our show's going to be a little different. As you all know, you read in the papers that my good partner, little Jerry, hurt himself. He just got out of the hospital yesterday. But we're going to have a lot of fun. And right now, we're all going up to his house, and, well, we're going to have a lot of fun. So let's all go up and see Jerry Lewis. Here we go.
I'm glad you came over. I was going to show all the gang some film that we have for my TV shows.
All the gang?
Yeah, hey, you want to see some of the film, fellas? Yeah!
I got a big living room, ain't I?
Sure.
Well, you know what I got, Dean? I got the opening, I got some sketches, I got some terrific film.
Everything on this little roll here?
Yeah, you know, this is my hobby with film and everything.
Sure, this hobby costs about 60 thou. Yeah. All right, now, look, you got an opening sketch there?
You don't know what the opening is, though, see?
Oh, I hope it's the airport thing.
The airport opening? How did you guess? Oh, pray tell. How did you guess? Well, that's exactly what it is. Shall we put it on?
All righty.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Yeah, you gonna put it on right away?
Yeah. Oh, before I do, would you like to have something to drink?
Oh, yeah. How about some milk?
All right. Jackson, would you get Mr. Martin some milk, please?
Milk? Put it on.
Okay, we're gonna put this on.
Let's look, Dean. Oh, this is gonna be terrific.
Boy,
well, you'll remember
this
too.
This
is terrific. Watch this. Oh, I'm so nervous.
Boy, I hope they put it on.
Yes, they will. Watch it.
And there are a lot of people here waiting to greet two celebrities who are about to come out of this plane that has just landed here now. And I think that any minute our two stars are about to make their appearance. I'll check again on that. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, here they come. Here they are. I want you to give them a great big welcome. Nobody liked them. Here they are, Martin and Lewis. Yes, sorry, ladies and gentlemen, Tony Martin and Joe Lewis. Now tell me, Tony Martin and Joe Lewis, I know that you're busy with the press photographers. I know that you're busy with the reporters, but I'm sure that you'd like to say a few words to our NBC network.
Hey, what's going on here? Come on, break it up. Get out of the way. What are you calling?
Hey, wait a minute. Who are you pushing around?
Yeah, well, what kind of a thing is this?
We're Martin and Lewis. I'm Tony Martin. That's Joe Lewis.
Yeah, well,
it's our
show, boy.
Sure, it's our show. What's your name?
Dean Martin. I've been anxious to meet you.
Why?
I hear you've been singing my song in the nightclubs.
What song?
There's No Tomorrow.
There's No Tomorrow? My mother used to sing that to me when I was a kid.
She must have stolen it from me.
She didn't steal it from you, and don't talk about my mother like that.
Tell me, get off.
Get off the stage.
No.
Mom, get off of the stairs!
I'm going to want to get off of the stage.
Well, I can't do anything with him.
See what you can do with him.
We'll be waiting around, you know, and you're going to win the championship next time. And I just want to say that, Joe, I usually, you know, take care of guys when they hit my partner. But you want to go with Tony somewhere? Tony!
Hey, fellas, that was a terrific opening, wasn't it, fellas? Yeah. Did you like it, Dean? Did you like... Dean? Oh, Dean. Here, Dean. Oh, Dean.
Well, he can't be here because he's getting ready for his number. I would like to introduce this song, though. Seriously, ladies and gentlemen, this is a song that means an awful lot to both Dean and myself. Would you mind coming a little closer, please? This song means a lot to Dean and I because it's a beautiful song. We heard this song the very first time in Cleveland, and it was sung by Andy Devine. And these are jokes. Now let's face. But it is a very beautiful number, and it's entitled "I'll String Along with You" from that beautiful picture, The Rope.
Meet the Martins, one of the millions of American families that use Colgate dental cream. Mother and father, and two healthy children. Hey, kids, why do you like Colgate dental cream?
It's the swellest tasting toothpaste in the world.
Sure is.
We know that brushing teeth right after eating with Colgate dental cream stops unpleasing breath and helps stop tooth decay. Our dentist told us
Colgate dental cream instantly stops unpleasing breath in 7 out of 10 cases that originate in the mouth. And the Colgate way of brushing teeth right after eating is the best home method known to help stop tooth decay. It stopped more decay for more people than ever before reported in dentifrice history.
And something else we found about brushing teeth right after eating with Colgate dental cream. It makes your mouth feel cleaner longer, gives you a clean, fresh mouth all day long.
So join the millions of Americans who brush their teeth right after eating with pure, white, safe Colgate dental cream to stop unpleasing breath, stop tooth decay.
Brush your teeth with Colgate. Colgate dental cream, it cleans your breath.
What a toothpaste.
What it cleans your teeth.
Martin and Lewis,
Dean
comic
Martin and Jerry Lewis comic books. Number 5 is on a newsstand. I'll buy it. We need the money. Dean, we got our TV award from TV Forecast in Chicago. Isn't that sweet?
From Forecast in Chicago.
TV Forecast. They made us the best comedians.
Why? What did we ever do?
I don't know, but they gave it to us.
Oh, all right.
Well, I can split it up. You'll get the wood. I'll keep the rest. I'm going to put on another film now. This is a terrific one, Dean. I bet you won't know which one this is, a sketch.
Oh. What?
I bet you won't know which this I had lived. I don't know where I am.
I know. Is that the Lay Garrick?
No, it is a sketch.
This is the one we had so much fun. What are you smoking, Chesterfield?
Yes.
Oh, that's our brand, because that's our sponsor on radio. Money, money, money.
All right, well, let me see. This is the pale lights. The eyeball sketch?
No.
The gum head?
No.
Well, let me see it.
All right. Watch this one. This is a terrific one. I'm so nervous because I laugh at us all the time.
You should. Boy. Hey, that's boy.
A nice turkey dinner?
I certainly did, Mr. Martin.
Well, that's nice.
Delicious
okay.
Turkey.
Good.
But you're late, Mr. Martin. Your company will be here any minute.
Well, I was tied up a little bit over the employment agency. I hired a new valet, you know. Did he get here yet?
He sure did.
Well, that's good.
That's what you think.
What? Oh. I'm Mr. Martin. What are you?
Oh, I'm your new valet, sir.
You're my valet?
Yes, sir.
Hot diggity dog.
Yes, sir. I'm your gentleman's gentleman, sir. And I'm here to see that everything is just fine and dandy. Ha, 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 ha.
What's your name?
My name is Dudley, sir.
Dudley.
They all thought I was going to say Melvin.
You smell something burning?
Burning?
What's burning here? What's burning?
Oh, my goodness, I dropped them. Sorry, sir, I'll have it
weaved. Yeah, you'll have it weaved. Hello. My fiancé is coming over. She's
your fiancé, the girl you're going to marry?
Yeah, she's coming over for dinner, and she's bringing her pop and her mop with her. Mom with her. So I figured, you sir. Have you ever served before? I want you to serve dinner. Have you ever served before?
Have I ever served before? I work for the Morgans, the Astors, the Rockefellers, the Birds, and the Queens. And you have the nerve to ask me, have I ever served before?
Have you?
Well, no.
No.
Very nicely, I will.
Well, all right, that's okay. And you watch it. Would you mind fixing my tie?
Oh, not at all, sir. I would like very much to do that so that you will be tidy and neat so when you... No, just 1 minute. I'll have to get this...
Well, now, Sheriff, I didn't kill that woman.
No, sir, no. I just want to fix this tie so that it's very nice and it's very neat. I can't seem to get the...
Well, I'll have my cufflinks here.
Yeah, wait, just 1 minute, sir.
Nice time for Hybe to call.
What? Yeah. Oh, I don't know Hybe.
Make it short, will you, buddy?
Make it short, will you, bud? He don't even know you.
Oh, there's my fiancée. She's coming in the door. Pick your shirt up. Take everything away. Now watch it. Pick up the ashtray. We're going to have a party. Take off the laundry. Hurry, 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 hurry. Let's go. Come on. Well, answer the door. Dignity, dignity.
No, my name is Douglas.
No. Use dignity when you're hazy.
Dignity. All right, here we are. Here, let the old lady sit over here.
Some martinis.
Get some what?
Martinis. You heard of martinis?
Sure, the martini.
I don't know. It came in a basket.
Oh, he's so strange.
Are you looking for it? I don't know.
I think that we're going to be all right.
Yeah, ladies. La da 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 da.
Johnny, you serve the mother first.
La da da da.
Get your foot off there! Well, you brought up in the barn?
You forgot the olive?
Heavens to Betsy, he's right.
What if you like his pipe?
Oh, I don't.
Do you want to hear the olive?
The sweat dripping down now? This is not spit. We're working.
Oh, here's a wishbone. Isn't that remarkable that you found it in there where I put it?
Why don't we break it for good luck? What do you say to that, fella?
With me.
We better hurry. I don't care if you people walking out in the back, but they're beginning to walk towards us.
Yeah.
Hurry.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
pretty hard wishbone, isn't it? Don't fall, because I'm doing the joke. Here we go.
Nationwide chain, Bob Stanton reporting. From chain stores, from small country general stores, drug stores, neighborhood dealers, huge supermarkets all over America, comes news that nature's chlorophyll in every cake of palm olive soap is changing America's buying habits. Nature's chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green.
No therapeutic claim is made for the chlorophyll, but you should know this about palm olive. Doctors have proved that Palm Olive's beauty plan brings most women lovelier complexions in 14 days. Gently massage Palm Olive Soap's extra mild, pure lather onto your skin for just a minute, three times a day. Rinse and pat dry. Remember, doctors have proved Palm Olive's beauty results. In fact, Palm Olive's beauty plan is far better for your skin than just average care with any leading toilet soap. Yes, Palm Olive brings out beauty while it cleans your skin.
Today, buy the regular or bath-sized palm olive, the chlorophyll green soap with the pure white lather. Same wrapper, same low price. Yes, nature's chlorophyll is in every cake of palm olive soap. Nature's chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green.
Do you have to chew that loud?
I take a penny and I'm gonna get my penny's worth, sir.
I run this library.
Is it a civil service job?
Yes.
Well, let's be a little more civil.
Now, what is it? What can I do for you?
Oh, I don't know. I just came here, and I want to return some of these books.
Why? What's wrong with
them? Oh, there's nothing wrong with them, sir. I just finished them using them, and I don't want them no more.
All right, let me have
them. All righty.
Come on.
roast down at the annual Y Dam Sunday.
All right. Give me your card. Give me your card, will you, buddy?
I must have left my card home.
I don't care where you must have left it. Give me the card.
I don't got it.
You don't got it. What kind of English is this? I don't got it. That's as bad as up the street. The soldiers, they're coming down. Let's talk the price, Buster.
What do you want from me? All I know is I ain't got a card. What do you want?
Well, get a card.
Maybe I can borrow my friend Herbie.
Go ahead, borrow Herbie.
I'll call Herbie.
Where's Herbie live?
Oh, just about a mile from here.
All right, call it.
Herbie!
Academy 72467 24771 3299 84 72111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111111
been changed to Academy
want that book I came for.
All right. What would you like to read?
Gulliver's Travels.
What?
Gulliver's Travels, and I want the book now.
Gulliver's Travels?
Yes, sir.
Do you happen to know where that book is?
No, I don't, but I want that book.
Will you get the book?
Yes, sir, if I will.
It's up there.
I'm not leaving
until
I get it.
Well, I haven't got a lantern that can't get it.
I want a book.
Humphrey.
I'm hungry.
You got a letter, sir?
I haven't
got a... No letter.
I got a letter. A letter's broken, but maybe we can help him out some other way, okay?
Here, put the table up here instead and put his chair
hey,
up.
Hey, that's a good way, Humphrey.
Yeah, here, let him stand on top of the chair. Get up there.
Yeah, go ahead. Get up.
Well, I have to go get the book.
Travels, you're gonna get it, Shorty.
I don't want to read it.
You get up here.
Hurry up. Did you drop your hat, Melvin?
Melvin?
Not with
the other.
Get up here. Get up here first. Step up here.
Why is he ad libbing?
I don't know, but I'm lost.
Put your hand up there first.
And it is.
And one foot up here now.
One foot.
Don't worry, I'm with you, buddy.
Your new wash is ready to use, Mrs. Stone. And here's a box of Fab to get you off to a good start.
Thanks a lot. Tell me, does Fab really get clothes whiter without bleaching, like they say?
It sure does. And if you'll go down to the Fab Test Laundry, the washing expert will show you.
Yes, Mrs. Stone. Fab washes clothes whiter without bleaching. Yes, whiter than any other product known, with the bleach in the wash water. Just look into the microscope. See, this piece of toweling was washed with soap and bleached. Just look at the deposits of soap scum. Compare it with this piece washed in just Fab without a bleach. Fab gets out dirt, leaves no soap scum, so clothes are really clean. Now, here are the two pieces together.
What a difference.
In hardest water, Fab washes cleaner than any soap on earth. What's more, washable colors look brighter with Fab. And it's mild to hands, too. Why don't you try Fab for a whiter, cleaner, sweeter-smelling wash?
Yes, next time you go marketing, get Colgate's new Fab. Find out for yourself why more and more in every store, the folks all grab for Fab.
ladies and gentlemen, right now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce a young man that Jerry and I think a lot of. We heard this young man sing. He has a very beautiful operatic voice. We know you'll enjoy him. And so all I have to say is a very good friend of mine and Jerry's, Mr. Salvador Inski.
Jim Dandy and Peachy and all that sort of stuff. I mean that with all my heart.
You're still in the hospital.
Listen now.
What are you?
I didn't say it. Don't laugh. Listen, Dave, seriously, I thought it would be nice that you sang a number. Wouldn't it be swell if I sang a number?
We couldn't possibly.
Well, on the radio,
why won't you see your name? I heard a fella say, Rodeo Doom.
Oh, no, the Randy show is next. All right.
I'm going to tell you why you can't do a song.
Tell me why I can't, won't you?
It's almost 9 o'clock. That means it's time to go. I guess we'd better say so long before we close the show. And trooper that you are, tonight as in the past, all although you couldn't work the show, you showed up in the cast.
Oh, you'll never get away, 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 you'll never get away. I guess you think it's fun, that hospital's no treat. There's nothing there to do all day, just loaf and sleep and eat. The nurses rub your head, the nurses rub your back. There's pretty nurses all around, and Dean, I'm going back.
You really had us scared.
You all thought I was dead.
It surely was a lucky thing.
I landed on my head.
Starting a new year.
Yes, sir, it's 1953.
There is a new song on my lips.
There's water on my knee.
Hey, chair, now don't forget.
Forget, oh, what, pray tell?
I think you ought to thank the folks who prayed that you'll get well.
Oh, I didn't forget, Dean. As a matter of fact, I wrote a special verse for them.
You wrote a special verse? You mean with rhyme? A vice? A rhyme?
Yeah. Hey. Shall I sing it?
Go with my blessing.
I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart for the way you've always been concerned about me and my partner.
I think you ought to thank the folks very seriously in your own serious way.
I certainly can be serious if I want to.
All righty.
All right, I'll be serious.
Go ahead.
I want to thank you all. I'd like to say tonight, I appreciate those letters that you took the time to write.
Because lying there in that hospital, it was a lonely thing.
All right.
And I was lying there, the nurses with the needles and the doctors cutting
the
eyeballs.
Let's not get sick,
man. And with the head opened up, the blood...
Will you shut up?
Oh, you'll never get away, you'll never get away, you'll never get away.
Well, it won't be very long.
I'll be as good as new.
And we'll be out on tour again.
In nightclubs and theaters too.
Until we meet again. God keep you feeling great.
We'll see you on the road again. In Cleveland.
Detroit.
Newark.
Steubenville.
London.
Oh, Paris.
Rome. Theaters, nightclubs.
Motion pictures.
Television. Oh, boy, will we make money.
Oh, you'll never get away. You'll never get away. You'll never get away. You'll never get away. Everybody for putting up with all this wonderful nonsense that we...
You've been very wonderful, and please remember the Muscular Dystrophy Association's New York 8, New York. Remember Chesterfield,
and don't
remember...
forget, next week, Bob Hope.
And the week after, Ben Blue, produced by Ernest D. Glucksman, our wonderful producer who did such a great job tonight. You've been so very kind to put up with the difficulty. We thank you so much from the bottom of our heart.
Good night, and God bless
you all.
Good
night. See you soon.
Bye-bye. Bye.
The Colgate Comedy Hour has been presented by Colgate Dental Cream. Come out of brushless shaving cream. Fab, the new wash day suds. And Palmolive soap. Jay, Gordon B. Clark, and Ruth Seville. Be sure and tune in again next week at the same time, and the Colgate Comedy Hour will star Bob Hope with his guests Nelson Eddy and Margaret Whiting. 2 weeks from tonight, your star will be Ben Blue with his guests June Havoc, Bob Crosby, and Mimi Benzel. The Colgate Comedy Hour has been chosen to be shown overseas through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Portions of this program were broadcast by means of television recording. And now this is Hal Sawyer saying good night for the Colgate Comedy Hour, which has been presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feet Company, makers of quality products since 1806.